In this video, we're continuing on with the Dividing Radical Expressions worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Now for numbers 15 through 22, we have a binomial and the denominator. Now remember, a plus b times a minus b equals a squared minus b squared. So if our denominator is in the form of a plus b, we're going to be multiplying our value of 1, which is a minus b over a minus b. If our denominator is in the form of a minus b, our value of 1 is going to be a plus b over a plus b in order to get our denominator as a squared minus b squared. So let's go ahead and practice that in number 15. We're going to multiply by a minus b. So that's going to be 4 minus 4 times the square root of 5 over 4 minus 4 times the square root of 5. Now remember, our denominator is going to be a squared minus b squared. So that's 4 squared minus 4 times the square root of 5 squared. And then we'll need to distribute this 3 to both the 4 and 4 times the square root of 5. So that's going to be 3 times 4 minus 3 times 4 times the square root of 5. So simplifying, 3 times 4 is 12, so we'll have 12 minus 3 times 4, which is 12 times the square root of 5, all over 4 squared, which is 16, minus 4 times the square root of 5 squared, distributing that exponent of 2 to the 4 and to the square root of 5, we're going to get 4 squared, which is 16, times the square root of 5 squared, which is 5. So we'll have 12 minus 12 times the square root of 5, all over 16 minus 16 times 5, which is 80. So that's 12 minus 12 times the square root of 5, all over 16 minus 80, which is a negative 64. Now, in order to simplify, I know that 12 is divisible by 4, so the 12 in my first term and the second term are both divisible by 4, and negative 64 is divisible by 4. So I'll get 3 minus 3 times the square root of 5, all over negative 64 divided by 4, which is negative 16. Now I need to take care of this negative in my denominator, and I can do that by simply moving it up into the numerator. So I'll have negative 3 minus 3 times the square root of 5 all over positive 16. But I'll need to distribute that negative to the positive 3 and to my 3 times the square root of 5 that's subtracted. So I'll get negative 3 plus 3 times the square root of 5 all over 16. That's my solution in number 15. Let's continue on to number 16. In number 16, my binomial and my denominator ends in the form of a minus b. So I'm going to multiply by a plus b over a plus b. So that's negative 5 plus 3 times the square root of 3 over negative 5 plus 3 times the square root of 3. So in my denominator, I'll get a squared minus b squared, which is negative 5 squared minus 3 times the square root of 3 squared. And for my numerator, I need to distribute that 5. It will get multiplied to negative 5 and to 3 times the square root of 3. So 5 times negative 5 is negative 25, and then I'll add that to 5 times 3, which is 15 times the square root of 3. So I'll have negative 25 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over negative 5 squared is going to be a positive 25, and then I'm subtracting 3 squared, which is 9, times the square root of 3 squared, which is 3. So I'll have negative 25 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over 25 minus 9 times 3, which is 27. So that's going to be negative 25 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over negative 2. Now, in order to get that negative out of my denominator, I'm going to move it up into the numerator. So essentially, I'm going to be multiplying by negative 1 over negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 25 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over negative 2 times negative 1, which is a positive 2. Negative 1 distributed to negative 25 and the 15, I'll get positive 25 plus negative 15 or subtracting a positive 15 times the square root of 3 all over 2. That's my solution in number 16. In number 17, my denominator, that binomial is a minus b. So I'm going to be multiplying by a plus b over a plus b. That's negative 3 plus 3 times the square root of 3 over negative 3 plus 3 times the square root of 3. So starting with my numerator, 5 times negative 3 is negative 15 plus 5 times 3 is 15 times the square root of 3. And again, that was distributing my 5 to each term. Now for my numerator, that's a squared minus b squared. So negative 3 squared minus 3 times the square root of 3 squared. So this equals negative 15 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over negative 3 squared, which is 9, minus 3 squared, which is 9, times the square root of 3 squared, which is 3. So I'll have negative 15 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over 9 minus 9 times 3, which is 27. So that's negative 15 plus 15 times the square root of 3 all over 9 minus 27, which is a negative 18. Now 15 and 18 are all divisible by 3. However, as opposed to dividing them by a positive 3, I'll divide by a negative 3 so that I can remove my negative from the denominator. So negative 15 divided by negative 3 is a positive 5 plus 15 times the square root of 3 divided by a negative 3 is going to be a negative 5 times the square root of 3, but as opposed to adding a negative, I'll subtract that positive 5 times the square root of 3, and then negative 18 divided by negative 3 is a positive 6. So 5 minus 5 times the square root of 3 over 6. For number 18, my binomial is in the form of a minus b, so I'll multiply by a plus b over a plus b. So that's the square root of 2 plus 5 times the square root of 3 over the square root of 2 plus 5 times the square root of 3. So my denominator is a squared minus b squared. So that's the square root of 2 squared minus 5 times the square root of 3, that quantity squared. My numerator, distributing my 4, will be 4 times the square root of 2 plus 4 times 5, which is 20 times the square root of 3. Simplifying, I'll have 4 times the square root of 2 plus 20 times the square root of 3 in my numerator, and in my denominator, the square root of 2 squared is 2, and I'll be subtracting 5 squared, which is 25, times the square root of 3 squared, which is 3. So I'll get 4 times the square root of 2 plus 20 times the square root of 3, simply rewriting my numerator, and then in my denominator, I'll have 2 minus 25 times 3, which is 2 minus 75. And 2 minus 75 is going to give me a negative 73 in my denominator. So there's no numbers that go into each of those terms evenly, but I still need to get this negative out of my denominator. So I'll be multiplying by negative 1 over negative 1. So I'll get negative 4 times the square root of 2 minus 20 times the square root of 3 all over a positive 73. That's my solution for number 18. And just a quick reminder that I'm multiplying by a plus b because that binomial was a minus b. And a minus b times a plus b equals a squared minus b squared. And a square root squared will give me the value that's just within the radicals, essentially removing those radicals from the denominator. For number 19, we'll be multiplying by a minus b over a minus b. So that's negative 4 minus 4 times the square root of 2 over negative 4 minus 4 times the square root of 2. So in our denominator, a squared minus b squared is negative 4 squared, which is 16, minus b squared, which is 16 times 2. Because 4 squared is 16, and the square root of 2 squared is 2. For my numerator, I'm going to have to FOIL because I have two binomials. So multiplying my first terms, 2 times negative 4, then adding that to my outside terms, 2 times negative 4 times the square root of 2. Since that 4 times the square root of 2 is subtracted, that'll be 2 times negative 4 times the square root of 2. And then my inside terms, 5 times the square root of 3 times negative 4. So adding 5 times the square root of 3 times negative 4. And then lastly, my last terms, which is 5 times the square root of 3 times negative 4 times the square root of 2. So now I'm going to start by simplifying my numerator. 2 times negative 4 is negative 8, plus 2 times negative 4 times the square root of 2 is negative 8 times the square root of 2, plus 5 times the square root of 3 times negative 4 will be negative 20 times the square root of 3, plus 5 times negative 4 is negative 20 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 2, which is the square root of 6. And that's all over 16 minus 16 times 2, which 16 times 2 is 32, so 16 minus 16 times 2 is 16 minus 32, which is a negative 16. Now, because each of my radicals have a different value inside, I'm not going to be able to combine any of my like terms. However, 8, 20, and 16 are all divisible by 4. So each of my terms are divisible by 4, and at the same time, I multiply by negative 1 over negative 1 in order to get that denominator positive. So my negative 8, when multiplied by negative 1, is a positive 8, and 8 divided by 4 is 2. So I have 2 plus, again, 2 times the square root of 2 plus negative 20 times negative 1 is a positive 20, and divided by 4, that's 5. So positive 5 times the square root of 3 plus, again, a positive 5, but this time times the square root of 6. And that's all over negative 16 times 1, which is a positive 16, but divided by 4 is equivalent to 4. So my final solution in number 19 is 2 plus 2 times the square root of 2 plus 5 times the square root of 3 plus 5 times the square root of 6 all over 4. In number 20, I'll be multiplying by a plus b. So that's 4 plus the square root of 5 over 4 plus the square root of 5. And again, I'm going to be FOILing for my numerator. So first, outside, inside, last. My first terms, square root of 5 times 4. So that's 4 times the square root of 5 plus the square root of 5 times the square root of 5 plus my inside terms, 2 square root of 2 times 4 plus my last terms, 2 square root of 2 times the square root of 5. And this is all over a squared, 4 squared, which is 16, minus b squared, the square root of 5 squared, which is 5. So simplifying my numerator, I'll have 4 times the square root of 5 plus the square root of 5 times the square root of 5 is 5 plus 2 times 4 is 8 times the square root of 2 plus 2 times the square root of 2 times 5, which is 10. And that's all over 16 minus 5, which equals 11. And because 4, 5, 8, 2, and 11 do not have any numbers in common, this is the simplest form. 4 times the square root of 5 plus 5 plus 8 times the square root of 2 plus 2 times the square root of 10 divided by 11. And number 20, my binomial and my denominator is in the form of a minus b. So I'm going to multiply by a plus b over a plus b. So that's 4 plus the square root of 5 over 4 plus the square root of 5. So again, FOILing in my numerator, I'll have the square root of 5 times 4, which is 4 times the square root of 5. And then I'll add my outside terms, the square root of 5 times the square root of 5. And then I'll add my inside terms, 3 times 4. And then lastly, my last terms, 3 times the square root of 5. And that's all over a squared minus b squared, which is 4 squared, which is 16, minus b squared, which is the square root of 5 squared, which is 5. So I'll have 4 times the square root of 5, plus square root of 5 times the square root of 5 is 5, plus 3 times 4 is 12, plus 3 times the square root of 5, all over 16 minus 5, which is 11. Now, in this case, I'll be able to simplify even further. Combining my like terms, I can combine 5 with 12, and I can combine 4 times the square root of 5 with 3 times the square root of 5. So 4 times the square root of 5 plus 3 times the square root of 5, 4 plus 3 is 7 times the square root of 5, plus 5 plus 12 is 17, and that's all over 11. Therefore, 7 times the square root of 5 plus 17 divided by 11 is a simplified expression in number 21. Now lastly in this video, I'll go over number 22. And this is also the last problem on the worksheet. If you found it helpful so far, don't forget to click that like button, and while you're at it, subscribe to my channel. Now that you've hopefully done both of those, our binomial and our denominator is in the form of a plus b, so we're going to multiply by a minus b. That's 4 times the square root of 5 minus 3 times the square root of 2 over 4 times the square root of 5 minus 3 times the square root of 2. So boiling in our numerator, we'll have 3 times 4 times the square root of 5, and then we'll add our outside terms, 3 times negative 3 times the square root of 2. And then taking into account these subtractions, I'm just writing them as negatives. And then I'll add my inside terms. So that's negative 4 times the square root of 3 times 4 times the square root of 5. And then finally, my last terms, negative 4 times the square root of 3 times negative 3 times the square root of 2. And then for my denominator, I'll have a squared minus b squared. That's 4 times the square root of 5 squared minus 3 times the square root of 2 squared. So simplifying, 3 times 4 is 12, so that's 12 times the square root of 5, plus 3 times negative 3 is negative 9, so negative 9 times the square root of 2, plus negative 4 times 4 is negative 16, and then I'm multiplying the square root of 3 times the square root of 5, which is the square root of 15, so negative 16 times the square root of 15, plus negative 4 times negative 3 is a positive 12, and then the square root of 3 times the square root of 2 is the square root of 6. And that's all over 4 times the square root of 5 squared, which is 16 times 5, 4 squared times the square root of 5 squared, and then I'll subtract 3 squared times the square root of 2 squared, which is 9 times 2. So now rewriting my numerator, I'll have 12 times the square root of 5 minus 9 times the square root of 2 minus 16 times the square root of 15 plus 12 times the square root of 6 all over my denominator, which 16 times 5 minus 9 times 2 is 80 minus 18, which is a positive 62. And this cannot be simplified any further because 12, 9, 16, 12, and 62 do not have any numbers in common. So 12 times the square root of 5 minus 9 times the square root of 2 minus 16 times the square root of 15 plus 12 times the square root of 6 divided by 62 is my final solution in this video. If you didn't do so before number 22, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Also, feel free to leave me a comment below.